This man, Hans Christian Gram, developed the Gram stain while working in a morgue. Although not created for this, the Gram stain is now commonly used as a first step in identifying bacteria based on the thickness of their cell wall. Working under a flame, I took isolates of bacteria from a plate I coughed on and put it into a drop of water on a glass slide. I repeated this with an isolate which I knew was E. coli. Crystal violet, the first stain, binds peptidoglycan in the cell wall. Next, iodine is added to form a complex with crystal violet. Ethanol is used to decolorize, washing away crystal violet from only gram-negative bacteria, which we then counterstain to give a red color. Gram stain generally divides bacteria into two groups, gram-positive and negative, but also allows us to see their morphology or shape. My first cough isolate is purple, so it's gram-positive and it looks spherical. My next isolate was also gram-positive, but this one was rod-shaped. Lastly, my E. coli sample is gram-negative and it looks red-pink. Comment and let me know what you think I found in my cough.